Okay, so we have a serious problem here. And unfortunately, it is going to get worse before it gets better. And there are some things that I feel need to be known and understood. Because this affects everyone on the planet. Everyone. And that is Fukushima. It's been several years since this disaster occurred. You would think because there is so little news, especially in the US, about Fukushima these days, you would like to think that they are getting things under control. Nope. They can't control it. They can't contain it. This is what they are not telling people. There is a fire of death burning in Japan right now. And the only one who can stop this is God. That's it. There is no stopping this. These freaking idiots have unleashed this beast upon us, folks. This is Japan's Godzilla. This is what you call a monster. So, this catastrophe occurred back in 2011, and since then, hundreds of millions of tons of radioactive water has leaked into the Pacific. Just to give you an idea of how big the Pacific is, just Google Earth the Pacific Ocean. It's pretty much half the planet. So, because it is about half the planet, we must consider that out of all the life on Earth, a great percentage of that life is in it. You see, plants and animals are not immune to radiation. They develop mutations and die off. So I can honestly not think of anything more haunting than the idea of a dead Pacific Ocean. But it's happening. There's no need to keep looking at some crazy map of the radiation plume spreading across the Pacific. It's everywhere now. It's in our water, it's in our food, it is in our tissue, and it will definitely be in our children's tissue. I think most people have seen this map by now, which is not a map of Fukushima radiation, but a map showing oceanic wave heights. These maps are just models, simulations based on the collected data at that time. They do not know exactly how much radiation is spewing out of the reactors or where it is going. The heavier radioactive particles sink into the ocean as the lighter particles get into the atmosphere, and there is a cumulative effect. Aside from the air blowing around radioactive dust, the entire ecosystem of the ocean is contaminated, and anything coming out of that ocean onto someone's dinner plate will contaminate the person eating it. And it gets worse, folks. Much worse. You see, I don't think many people get what this means. Because of this radiation, everything will begin to literally fall apart. Understand that this radiation affects everything that is a thing. Metal, rock, concrete, all that, yes. Because these radioactive particles knock holes in the atomic matrix of matter. So metal will weaken. It will affect electronic circuitry. They keep sending in these robots, and they can't even get a photo to see what's going on because the robots literally melt when they get too close. That's why more and more planes are going to start falling out of the sky, like they have been. You're going to have more train derailments. You're going to see large structures fail and collapse. Get this, amusement park rides are beginning to lose their structural integrity as well. Now this is known as the Wigner effect, and it is very real. This is when neutron radiation causes the displacement of atoms within an object or matter. It in fact changes the object. There is no element on this planet that can contain this nuclear material. Even the power plants that are currently active leak radiation. Lead doesn't stop it, it only slows it down. This is why you need so many layers of it for it to be effective. Over time, this stuff will decay anything. They have to keep replacing the sarcophagus in Chernobyl because the radiation just keeps eating through whatever they bury it in. And this nuclear material over at Fukushima is just burning through the floor into the ground. All they can do is just keep flooding it with water that they have to then store in large containers that are not welded but bolted together. These things are leaking radioactive water like crazy, and the amount of radiation coming out of these reactors is increasing. It is a true horror show, ladies and gentlemen. And now the evacuated areas have been taken over by wild radioactive boars. And they are attempting to move people back in. I can't make this stuff up. I can't. And it really brings me to tears knowing that the people of Japan are not going to be well off as a result of this. And we may be witnessing what will be the complete death of this country and its people. But it's not just Fukushima, folks. The Halden nuclear reactor in Norway is raising concerns because it is failing and they are releasing radioactive particles into the air through ventilation to keep the reactor from melting down. If you live on the east coast of the US, well, the Indian Point nuclear reactor has been leaking tritium into the water and God knows what else. And to top it off, they built this thing on a fault line. You see, folks, construction for many of these nuclear plants begin in the 50s. And these facilities only have a lifespan of about 40 years. It is now 2017. You do the math. These reactors are due to fall apart. And some of these madmen don't care. And just to show you how sick these madmen are, I want you all to go take a look at the time-lapse map of every nuclear explosion from 1945 to 1998. Now this map is obviously not current, but the radiation given off by these bombs still is. And guess who's responsible for detonating the most nukes? I'm telling you, you may get freaked out by watching explosion after explosion on this time-lapse. I'm talking about more than a couple thousand detonations worldwide. And we act like this is normal. This doesn't look good. It really doesn't. Radioactive elements mimic nutrients such as calcium and potassium in the body. And this radiation, these macronutrients, are readily absorbed by the body, especially if you are mineral deficient. This is why I stress cleansing and trace mineral supplementation, as well as investing in a Geiger counter to test your food. This may not be the end of mankind and everything else, but we are definitely on the road to total destruction. If we don't make some moves to use methods of creating energy that won't kill us all, there are going to be some changes occurring around the world. And we may have to take some steps backward before we can fix this. If we can fix this at all. But I believe not all will be lost. And we will get through this in the end. Knowing that we have finally been released from the hands of madness.